Now, children, I have explained you what is angle. In angle, you have two lines, which is also called as arms, and you have a vertex here. Now, in this, children, I am going to show you and draw a triangle. There is a difference between the angle and a triangle. Angle is an open figure and triangle is a closed figure. But first you have to draw an angle, then you close it and it becomes a triangle. Now see, first I draw a line, then I draw another line. If when you draw this, children, you use a ruler. Here I am showing you in freehand. Now, when you close these two points, what is this? This is a triangle. So the difference between this is that this is open and this is closed. Now you have a vertex in the triangle also. And what is this? Is a corner of the triangles. Angle has two sides, triangle has three sides. Tri means three and angle means 1, 2, 3. Now, and triangle also has a name. You can write any alphabet here, like P, Q and R. Now for angle, you use this symbol and you write P, Q, R. And for triangle, you use this symbol and you write triangle P, Q, R and read it also as triangle P, Q, R. Now, children, in angle, you have done acute angle, obtuse angle, straight angle and right angle. Now, these angles, when they are closed, they become a triangle. And now, this you will read according to the angles. Now see here, the first one is acute angled triangle. Now see, this is like this, okay? Now children, why this is acute angled triangle? Because here all the angles will be less than 90 degree. Why? Because the sum of a triangle is equal to 180 degree. What is the sum of the triangle is? Here I am writing sum means when you add the three angles, the answer will be 180 degree. The sum of the triangle is equal to 180 degree. Now suppose this is 60 degree, this is 60 degree and this is 60 degree. So when you add this, you will get the answer 180 degree. But all the triangles are less than 90 degree, so it is called acute angled triangle. Now second one, obtuse angled triangle. Now children, here obtuse, you know, is more than 90 degree and less than 180 degree. So here in this, you will have at least one angle as obtuse. Okay. Now see, I will show you here how. This is what? 100 and you take it as 110. And then here you have 30 degree and here you have 40 degree. So now when you add this children, 110 and 40, 150 and 30 degree, you will write, see, the answer will be 180 degree. But one angle is 110, so it is called obtuse angled triangle. Then you have next as right angled triangle. Now children, in right angled triangle, it is always in this shape. Now see here, this means that here at least one angle should be 90 degree. And always remember that in a triangle you don't have two 90 degree angle, only you have one. Now this is 45 degree and this is 45 degree. So when you add this, you will again see the answer is 180 degree. So children, you will see that in triangle, according to the degree, according to the angle, when you get the answer 180 degree, you can find out which kind of angle it is. So acute angle triangle, obtuse angle triangle and right angled triangle. So these are the three angles which you can read according to their angles. Now next children, I am going to tell you about different type of triangles which you read according to their sides. The first one is equilateral triangle. Now children, equi means equal. So here you have all the three at 60 degree and you have all the three sides of equal measurement. Means if this is 3 centimeter, so this is also 3 centimeter and this is also 3 centimeter. They should be equal and the sum will also be 180 degree. Next is scalene triangle. Now children, in scalene triangle, all the three sides are of different length. See, here I am drawing it. This is 7 centimeter, this is 8 centimeter and this is 4 centimeter. This I am writing to explain you. So children, when you have all the three sides of different length, that is called scalene triangle. Next is isosceles triangle. See, in isosceles triangle you have the opposite sides equal, means this and this. And this is of different length. This can be 5 centimeter and this can be 3 and the opposite side will also be 3 centimeter. And remember, you can draw these angles also. Why? Because they are the vertex of the angle. So children, now here you have the triangles which you can read according to the sides: equilateral triangle, scalene triangle and isosceles triangle. So children, I have explained you and now I am going to send you the solved exercises which you will do in your register and use pencil for drawing the diagram. If you have any problem, any doubt, children, you can ask in the group. Thank you.